San Francisco is focused.
San Francisco is full of serendipity.
San Francisco is intense, beautiful chaos.
San Francisco is a vibrant microcosm of many cultures.
San Francisco is the frontier. To be a successful entrepreneur, you have to be sort of like all consumed. The city really lends itself to people who are like-minded, and that's why people love to build here.
People here are pretty intense, plus like everything they do. If they run marathon. If they bike, they do like Ironman, and that pushes you to just be better. My name is Kathleen Voss. I'm the co-founder and CTO of Elo. We built an AI reading teacher, giving every child a one-on-one learning companion and trust-inspired love for reading. We work in the mission. Being here is stimulating, sometimes overstimulating to say the least, but it's really colorful, it's really vibrant, and it's like really chaotic, but sort of structured chaos, I think, is so much of like what a startup is and so much of like an environment that I thrive in. So I love being in the middle of that. We believe that education is going to be one of the most impactful applications of AI. What we haven't been able to do is actually scale that one-on-one interaction. And AI fundamentally gives us that opportunity.
San Francisco, as a city, has had a really big comeback moment during this new wave of AI. We're sitting here at a loft space where we're focusing in on the generative AI ecosystem.
These communities are actually not new. They've existed since the 1500s. People would meet to talk about science and astronomy, and we're seeing that again, where people are coming together with this new technology. That's why I love the AWS lofts, because you guys bring all of these different types of people together, and you are a part of a history that's been around for years.
I'm Lavanya. I work at Weights & Biases. Weights & Biases builds developer tools for AI engineers. Our community was the reason we became the number one experiment tracking tool. People weren't just buying a tool when they were buying us. They were getting this community and access to these people who were talking about their favorite paper, talking about their favorite tool. And the amount of things that are happening in just like this couple block radius is insane. That's one of the things I love about the city, because the serendipity of the city doesn't happen anywhere else. I'll be walking to get my coffee and I'll run into someone who's also working on an interesting startup, and we'll be like, hey, do you want to do something together? That's where that starts.
So it's just fantastic to be surrounded by people of all cultures, all different technical backgrounds, and people who are just passionate about building the future. I've been dreaming of this future with robots around us since I was a kid. And it's just heartening to see that it's happening in our lifetimes. In fact, it's happening in front of our eyes. I'm Samir, founder and CEO of Dexterity Inc. At Dexterity, we've been working to create the next generation of AI that would power intelligent robots to achieve human-level skill and dexterity at a wide variety of tasks. It is absolutely encouraging to see the types of investment that AWS is making in creating infrastructure that makes the lives of startups like us much, much easier.
It's incredibly isolating to be a founder. And so having other founders with you on that journey is extremely important for the success of the ecosystem and the community.
My first job out of school was a software development engineer. The type of community that AWS has created simply did not exist back then for me.
Few great things are done alone. It's pretty essential to have people that are going through similar stuff that you're going through. And so the density of those types of people is just higher here than anywhere else in the world.
I'm really fortunate that we started Dexterity in the Bay Area. I couldn't imagine starting it up anywhere else.
And this is just at the very start of the journey. So, you know, it'll only get better from here, the kinds of things that people can build. I think the way the community has changed is it's become something that anyone can walk into and feel like they can participate in.